Hi guys, it's Meliaa. So I hate washing my hair. I'll put it off for as long as possible because one, it's coloured and I hate washing it to get rid of the colour, and two, I'm just really lazy and it's a lot of effort and I can't bother. So I decided today to show you three hairstyles that I do that help kind of hide all hair flaws, from bad hair days to dirty hair, just to put it off a little bit longer, and they're really quick to do as well. So I hope you like this video and please give them a go. So the first hairstyle is going to be the messy bun. I love doing this. Some days it goes really well and I get the right kind of messy effect, and some days it doesn't, but it's really quick. So the first thing you want to do is grab a hairband, for one, and grab your hair and just put it up into kind of a ponytail, and then it's up to you. What I then choose to do is twist it as much as I can and wrap it round into a quite tight top knot. Then grab your hairband and just kind of loosely secure it so you've got some kind of really high bun. Leave it like that if you want to, but then what I try and do is I will pull it out to kind of give it a little bit of extra room, and then kind of hide more of your hair as well, which is quite helpful. And then just do it as much as you need to, and then clip it in place. Done. Okay, and that's the first one done. Took me all of about 5 minutes. You can pin it to make it easier if you want to, and it actually works better if your hair's a bit dirty, because then at least you get more volume. And yeah, so one accomplished. Okay, so second technique is the fishtail plait. Obviously you can do a normal plait as well, but I always find with a fishtail you can really control kind of messed up hair and really bad hair days. So we're going to do this one next. So first thing you want to do is pick a side. I normally have a middle parting, but I think for the fishnet you kind of need to have fishtail, even you need to have it on one side, so I'm going to pick this side. So tuck your hair over to one side, just give it a quick brush because I'm pretty sure it's going to be knotted. Cool. And then what you want to do is grab your hair and separate it into two sections of the same length, hopefully. Like so. And then you're going to want to grab a section from the back, about this much, like a thin strand, and cross it over to the other side and grab that with your other hand, like this, and then do the same on the other side, section of hair, grab it round, and like that, and then carry that on all the way down. When you get to the bottom, it can be quite tricky to carry on doing the fishtail effect, so then I usually just finish it off with a normal plait, because you know, it's messy, who's gonna know the difference. And then once that's done, secure it with a hairband. I would recommend these clear ones because they're great, and just tie it up. And then once that's done, it's a little bit too perfect for me and I'll just mess it up a little bit by pulling it out, giving it a little bit more thickness, and then maybe pulling out some extra bits of hair. And there you go, one smaller fishtail plait, because I've cut my hair recently, but yeah, it works really well. And once again, this is probably the best one if you've got a really bad hair day, you just need to kind of pull it all into one. So that's the second one done. And the last hairstyle are these milkmaid braids. I love this one because if you've got really greasy hair or something like that, and for some reason you haven't been able to wash it, it kind of covers up pretty much the majority of your hair, so it's perfect. So for this one, all you need to do is set up your parting wherever you're going to put it. Once again, I'm going for a side parting. And then split your hair down the back into two sections, like this. And then you'll plait them normally on both sides. And then secure that one with a clear headband. And then do the same with the other side. Oh, it might be important to mention that if you want to leave some parts of your hair out, I would recommend it, then pull some out before they get too stuck in the braid. Okay, now we have our braids. What you want to do is just twist it slightly so this face is going to face up when we put it up. Twist it and then pull it over the top of your hair. And you can have it as far forward or as far back as you want it to. But once you've done that, and then pin it into place. And then do the same on the other side. The trick is try and cover up where the band is. Try and kind of wrap it over the top, but that'll come with experience, but you'll kind of see as you do it. So twisting, gonna place it over the band. And then I'm gonna try and tuck this bit underneath the other band. Once that's done, you can pull out the plait just to make it a little bit wider, kind of cover more of your hair as well. And then what I usually do is just kind of mess it up a little bit more, kind of a little bit back comb, just to give it a little bit of a messier effect. And then just give it a good pin wherever you want it to. Obviously this one will work better if your hair is longer, but like me, mine's about this length now, so you can still get it up there. You just do some really neat pinning, which I could probably have done a better job on this one, but I usually take more time on it. But there we go. So those are my three hairstyles to put off washing your hair until you absolutely get to the point where you need to. But I hope they helped you. If you have any other designs that you think work really well when you've dirtied your hair, let me know, because I would really like to know some more. But I hope this tutorial helped you. If it did, please do give it a thumbs up, subscribe today, and I'll see you next week. Bye!